There are a lot of different exercises that you can do to work out your arms, your chest, and your back. But people have a tendency to stay doing the same kinds of exercises once they learn a handful of them. If you're looking for some variety to spice up your workouts, then I've got you covered in this upper body dumbbell workout. Welcome back to Total Body Training. My name is John Carlos, and if you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, please click the subscription button. On this channel, we go over fitness tips, trends, and tutorials to help you stay informed and get in shape. And if you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. If it's not your thing, then give it a thumbs down. Today, we're going over 4 upper body exercises. These exercises will be for your biceps, your shoulders, your chest, and for your back. Let's jump into the video. We're gonna start this one off with the dumbbell row and tricep kickback. So we're gonna be engaging the traps and the lats in this movement, but we're also gonna be engaging the triceps, so the bottom part of your arm. You're going to start off with 2 dumbbells, and you're going to arch your spine and open up your chest and then bend over at the waist. Keep your spine very arched and your chest very open. And from there, you're going to let your dumbbells hang in front of you in the hammer grip position. You're going to row them up so that you feel engagement in their back, and then extend your arms back and behind you so that you feel the movement in your triceps. Then unextend the movement and then let the arms drop down. Again, when you bring it up, make sure that your forearms are in line with your sides. So they're rubbing against your sides or very close to the sides of your core. And then you're kicking back and then bringing it back down and then extending the arms all the way down. The most common mistake with this movement is not kicking back enough. When you're doing combo movements like this, generally what happens is that one muscle group is stronger than the other. The lats, your upper back muscles, are naturally bigger. They're anatomically bigger than your triceps. And if you've been working out correctly, then chances are your lats are stronger because they're bigger, naturally. So when you go and you row back, the weight that you can do in the row is typically heavier than the weight that you can do for your tricep. But when you're doing the row and the tricep kickback, you need to take into consideration that, yeah, sure, maybe you can row like 40 plus pounds, but maybe you can't kick back 40 plus pounds with the right amount of weight. So my suggestion for you is to go down in weight and play with the weight that's going to be more accommodating to the fact that you are combining these two movements together. And let's say that you don't like doing them together, you could just do the rows as a 2-arm dumbbell row, and then later on just do the tricep kickbacks alone. That way you're not really taking away from your row and you can focus on your kickback. Personally, that's more of what I would do, but this exercise is great if you're bored of just doing your rows the standard way. The next exercise is the dumbbell floor press. You are going to start off with 2 dumbbells on the ground. You can lay them side by side and then lay back and try to grab them. Or what you can do is place the dumbbells on your legs and then flip them up so that now you've got leverage. You've used your legs to help you flick the weight up and then rest back down on the ground. That's my preferred way to do it. From there, you're going to take your arms and rest your triceps, the entirety of your triceps, on the ground, and your elbows will also be resting on the ground, but your arms, your forearms, will be in a perpendicular angle facing up, like you're about to do a bench press or any other pressing movement where you're laying down. From there, you're going to push the dumbbells up in the air, touch the dumbbell heads together, let them touch, and then come back down. Bring those dumbbell heads up, and then come back down. The most common mistake with the floor press is not letting your arms rest on the ground. There's a good reason why this is the most common mistake. There's a really good reason why people get this one a little bit mixed up, and that's because this goes counter to how we generally do our bench press. When we're on a bench, our arms don't touch anything. They're not supposed to touch the ground. They're not supposed to touch the bench. That's not even something that's anatomically possible if you're doing the exercise correctly. So it feels a little bit weird to let your whole entire tricep touch the ground when you're doing the movement, but the fact of the matter is that when we're floor pressing, the goal here is to take all of the momentum out of the movement. When you rest your arms on the ground, you take the momentum out of the movement, thus making it harder to pick the dumbbells up off of the ground. And if you don't believe me, go grab the heaviest dumbbell that you can in the gym, try benching it on a bench press, and then try doing it on the floor. And you will see that it's a lot harder when you don't have the give that you get when you've got space from the bench not having a place for you to rest your arms on when you're bringing it down. So just make sure that when you're doing it, you're completely resting your triceps on the ground and then coming up and exploding up. The next exercise is the wide grip row. You're gonna grab your two dumbbells with an overhanded position. They're just gonna sit by your sides at this point. You're going to arch your spine and pinch your shoulder blades together and bend over at the waist while keeping that spine very arched and straight. You are going to bend over, not completely flat, just at a slight angle from the ground, and then bring your dumbbells up so they're in line with your sternum, right below the nipple line, and to the sides with a wide grip. If this was a barbell, you'd be holding it rather wide in the position. And then you're going to pull the dumbbells up, keeping your forearm perpendicular, straight to the ground, squeeze your back, and then come back down. Pull the arms back, rowing and feeling the activation in your lats and your rhomboids, and then bringing it back down. The most common mistake with this movement is doing it like you're doing a two-arm dumbbell row where the elbows are closer to your body. It's still a two-arm dumbbell row, it's just that the movement here is meant to activate other parts of your upper back more effectively. And so we want to make sure that we're targeting that by doing the wide grip version of it. And if you feel like you can't hold the dumbbells out in front of you with that wide position, it's probably because it's too heavy in weight. So my suggestion is to go down in weight so that you can find the right option for you and then build back up. But other than that, I mean, just make sure that you're keeping your arms in the same position on the way up and down. That's the most, really the most common mistake there, is just moving your arms in different positions while you're doing the exercise and changing the position of your elbow. Just keep it in line with your chest and with your sternum below the nipple line and you'll be just in the right position. The next exercise is the dumbbell curl and Arnold press. You're going to start off with two dumbbells at your sides and you're going to hold them with the dumbbell heads facing out and with the palms facing up. From there, you're going to pinch your elbows to your side, roll your shoulder blades back so your chest is open, curl the dumbbells up, try to keep the elbows by your side so you're not moving them too much, and bring them up a little bit higher than you normally do so that they are more in line with the shoulders or your the top part of your chest. And then from here, we're gonna start the Arnold part of the Arnold press part of the movement, where you're going to then turn your arms out so that the palms are facing away from you, and then bring the dumbbells up like you're doing a strict press, touch the dumbbell heads together, then bring them down, close your arms off so the palms are now facing towards you, uncurl your hands down, and then repeat. This movement is relatively simple, but something about the twisting motion sometimes throws people off. The most common mistake that I see with this movement is half repping. So people will get the curl right, and then they'll turn their arms out, but then when they go up to do the strict press part of the movement, they only go up like a part of the way, so the arms end up being, you know, just a little bit above your head. And in order to really engage your entire shoulder, your medial delt, and your front delt, and your posterior delt, you're gonna wanna make sure that you're coming up as high as you can and touching those dumbbell heads together, and then bringing back down. You will feel a difference when you're doing it correctly. Now, another really common mistake with this exercise is just not getting it down correctly and forgetting how to do it midway through the movement. So make sure that you watch this video like two or three times and really get the movement down. All right, people, and that does it for today's video. Question of the day: what is your favorite upper body group to work out? My favorite upper body group to work out right now is the chest, although it used to be the back. It's definitely the chest right now. And my favorite exercise is an incline barbell bench press or an incline dumbbell bench press. What's your favorite exercise to do? Let me know down in the comment section below. I love to hear from y'all and talk with you so that I can learn more about you and my community and how I can better service you. All right, people. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel so you never miss out on another video. Until next time, peace.